Well, now we have switched over to the Comanche for one short hop at the moment. We're going to fly from NZTL, 14 miles, fly over Glantanner, NZGT, then fly 8 miles north and land at Mount Cook, NZMC. Flying the Mustang is just amazing. It's really exhilarating and also occasionally terrifying. Landings are always exciting. So it's almost, well, it is relaxing to come to one of the Pipers. Yeah, destination airport's over here, but our flyover is over here. It might seem very docile to start off with, but once you get stabilized at an altitude, it picks up speed. This place is interesting because here's the runway and the main buildings. There's also a road that goes up here and you can park all the way up like here in the house, which I've done. It's kind of fun, just driving up a road on an airplane. Maybe on the way back I'll drop in and show you that, we'll see. The airport we're heading to is just up here. So here's the house. Here's the house where you park up here, actually. This road goes up here. Drive up this road here and you park here. I mean, I guess you can drive up further if you really want to. But there's Matt there. Our airport's just up here. Yeah. In fact, I'm thinking about what a touch and go here and another place because it's kind of more interesting. So I haven't done touch and go in here for a while. November 2, 1, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5 go practice. And it gives me a good chance to have a turn around that scary mountain area. It's a two click down on this. Okay. There you go, that's a decent go for you. Let's go back and see it again. Yeah, the gear on this is, the controller is two clicks down. One click kind of unlocks it. Easy mistake to make. Without a warning light, I would have landed belly up, which wouldn't have been fun. Let's go back and see that airport again closely. I want to go and park in that little spot I showed you in the airport. There's Matt Cook in there, but see, that was two clicks. The first click was not up, second click is. Chuck. Landing here, parking up there. Gear down, it's one click, two clicks, now you hear the gear now. That was a smooth landing. I don't know what.
To say that,
yeah. They didn't hear us. There wasn't even a squeak. Yeah. Not even a squeak or bump or whatever. Okay, we're going straight to our little parking space in the mountains. This is the runway here. This is the other runway. I'm not going to go on the road because there's cars there. But you can actually go, yeah, you go on the road. Last time I was here, I didn't have any cars. You can go on the road past that building up the top, but I won't do that. Well, I did it before. I drove up here and parked behind someone's house. That's why I really like this airport. Having this little, we want to hit that. Ricks. Yeah, you can go up the road there behind, see the parking lot up there? But that's not, I don't think planes are really supposed to go up there. Let's go. Road here, so you can take that taxiway. Matt Cook in the background there. We will explore that at some other trip. I can see a Mustang high flight coming. Some oxygen. Today we're heading south though. Whoop. Ooh, okay. Does that look like on the outside? Too good. I suppose we should just on a break and go. Bounce time. Obviously, you wouldn't do that in real life. I mean, it's some kind of interesting repeating effect here. Maybe it's a ghetto plane. It's actually, I guess that's a road, but it's really a appalling road. We're going to this runway here where we originally arrived. A bit flatter. There we go. Actually, that is a runway. That's where the wind's coming from. So, take advantage of it. Back up here. Turning right, but I just want to look at that for a few seconds. There we go, that's beautiful.
airport we're heading for is here,
20 miles away. Actually, that looks an interesting little ridge up here. Let's just fly up here. Maybe we can explore the landscape while we're here. Definitely Mustang territory there. I have to make a note of that. I guess if you're in a small plane, you could probably land on this little plateau. We won't. Airport's over here. Oh, there it is. That's the main runway. It's like landing on grass. Oh, we took off our grass. Let's see what the crosswind is. Oh, 77 knots. We'll land straight in at 17? 15. See if we can see the other runway when we get closer, the one we were originally thinking of landing at. Take it out. Sign of the other runway, because of the bump in earlier on, we're going to do a quick check on the engine. We'll take off again. The plane's airplane. Perfect little circle to go around. Stop is Alexandra, NZLX, nice little town. After that we'll be heading through the mountains to land at Queenstown, beautiful add-on airport from OrbX. think we need to climb up here to get above the mountains. Might use the GPS for fun here. To play safe, we will climb to 10,000. We'll steer this way to avoid the clouds. This cloud cover is only momentary. Alright, 15 minutes to go, 41 miles. That's 8,000 feet out. I'm 8,000 feet altitude. So, using the 1,000 feet per minute, three times the altitude calculation, we will start descending at 24 miles out, which is 12 miles time. Actually, allowing for, say, 5 miles stabilized speed, we can start descending in now, really. Looks like we're by 19. How we do that? I'm still landing, just looking at that view. That would be interesting. And part by grandpa over here, it's paper. Next leg is a short 30-odd mile trip to Queenstown, the add-on airport of OrbX. Beautiful airport. I've tuned my VOR in, but we're going to fly from memory a little valley route up there, which lines us up nicely with runway 25 or whatever it is. So runway. Don't think we have a taxi rate. We do. Cool. Traffic center is probably echoed off here. of this valley, as I mentioned, it's kind of a cool view. You can see some people and towns and a river and a dam. There's also a dam out here. The dam is just and I ride here to see if we can get a view of it. There we go, there's the dam. This is showing us where we want to go, which is, well, I'll leave that on now. Oh, well, I'm sorry. Don't like the GPS. Tend to steer it down instead of the scenery. We won't take that little, that's a little, as you can see, it goes in a little circle around here. So we're going to turn right down this valley here. Miles away. Get a good view of the beautiful airport coming in this direction. Now we're heading to the VOR because the VOR gives us the perfect approach to runway 14. We turn left pretty well at the VOR. Runway 14 is this direction. Here's the main 32, I think. Now coming into Queensland region. some ways there. Because we're GA, they don't consider this mountain, the hill, to be a problem. So our approach will be down here. Queenstown? There, I believe. So it's almost hard to see from the sky there. I think it's here. Okay. Yeah, there it is. Landing gear warning, but when the fog goes low, but that's okay, we're doing that deliberately. Well, where the gear's not down. Little hill, as I mentioned earlier. There's no real way you can approach this from, directly. You have to turn it because it's mountain. Which always makes it an interesting one. Mountains, beautiful. That. It's just sneak little. Let's see a sneak little way through here to GA Airport. The barrier down there, I think there's a gate. Well, it's not. We can sneak around here. Oh, sorry. Big airport, we have to talk to them. 121.9, Hyper 65 Romeo. There's actually a Milford Sound hangar for the tour, so we'll park there, which will make it very realistic. Ahead of us, we have Milford Sound flights. I think that one of my, well, it has to be my favourite add-on for OrbX is Milford Sound Airport. The scenery and the airport and the landing are just so challenging and fun. And when you're there, it's beautiful. So let's put us in a situation where we can see that. Turn flights without hitting this plane. probably be here. That'll do.